You know, what's funny about the Player Stage project is that when I was in grad school, we had these robots, and they came with some software on them that was all proprietary, and we couldn't do it. We couldn't fix bugs, and that was the norm. And we were trying to use the robots to do science experiments, but the robots themselves had problems. And at some point we thought, we're early computer scientists, we can throw this crap away and just build our own stuff. So we did that, and then we put it out on the internet where other people could see it. And then that very quickly became my personal passion. So then I was spending as much time as I could improving Player, which was the main thing that I worked on, which was kind of like a precursor to ROS in a way. And then I would go in for my weekly meeting with my advisor, and she would say, I would say, hey, I just put the following new features into Player. And she would say, for the love of God, stop doing that. That's never going to get you a PhD. You need to do science and write papers. And she was completely right. And I did do science to some extent and write papers and wrote a thesis and all that. But I never got tired of that feeling of writing something and getting it out in the world and getting the feedback from people who actually make use of it.